As you know, ASI has come now. Let's go to preferences, and here you can see the ASI. Yesterday I didn't cover the device configuration, and here you can select whatever device you want to bring into Resolve. It might be multiple inputs and outputs. Okay, you can select everything, and you need to relaunch Resolve. That's the main thing. And the next one is the latency. You can set the latency, whatever, like the playback processing and then buffer size and everything. Ideally 512 and 216 are preferred. The least latency is 32, which is very processor intensive, and 4000 above is for lower processor intensive but too much latencies. Even the buffer size, it's same as like that. Much lower latency is 0, and then the highest like that. And automatic speaker configuration, you can set it up, or else you can just keep it on auto manual and click on save, relaunch. So now you can go to Fairlight and patch input and output. Okay, in the patch input and output, you can assign whatever the inputs and outputs coming from ASO are going to your, this is set up for recording, so you can select audio inputs to the track input and patch it up so that you can get two different tracks with two different streams, like two different microphones audio, like two person interview or something like that. Even you can do it for the output also. You can have also talk back and everything in here. I just didn't find the option, so I'm skipping. And one more biggest problem of this is, if you are running Resolve, you cannot run any other application which can produce sound, like YouTube or anything. It can play back, but without audio, without zero audio. It's just like any other DAW, okay? So make sure you note the point. Even after refreshing so many times, putting the volume at 100, it didn't come. So there are various applications. Even you can have your own desktop audio, like Discord and everything, like every application type also coming into Resolve with using ASIO. Like you can see this video, it will be linked in the description. Like this is for voice meter, but you can assign the same way to the virtual cable and coming to the virtual cable into the Resolve, okay, adding it as an input. Let's talk about the changes in interfaces. The FX, EQ, DY, the order, the labeling has been done like FX blue, like FX yellow and EQ blue, like that, which is very convenient in my view, because it helps determine what is what going on. Next one is the transient detection. So the symbol has been changed a little bit, like it was before something, I don't know, I just forgot it after the update, okay. So now it has been like a curve with a dash and an arrow. So that is transient detection now. And you can also see the no more ghost scrubbing. Like if you are playing it and just like pushing your mouse somewhere else without selecting, it's no, now it's nothing. Okay. Next is the Fairlight audio interface settings. If you have an Fairlight audio interface, then this might be helpful for you. Okay. And you can do your settings over here. So next up is that you can turn on and off the clip gain line on the clip. So you can see over here, if I on and off, you can see the line appearing and disappearing. Okay, it will be useful for many use cases. And this is the, actually this location has been changed. It was first in the right click and then clip show the information and all, but now it's in the Fairlight tab. So just found out that one. Okay, so next one is you can reorder the buses in the track list, like bus 1, bus 2, you can reorder if you are in the track list like that. Yeah, as simple as it is, but not audio tracks. Okay, that's not an issue, but yeah, you can. So there are some new changes or new things in how you can scroll your timelines. So the one which I'm using, the default one, is just the right forward move, and the next one is center mode. Okay, like only if you move the center part will like be in the center like that. And next one is like only the like the tracks will move, the player will be at its playhead, like playhead is static to wherever it is. So these are the three new modes which came in 17.3. So this might be useful for you, okay? And moreover, there is a lot of improvement in zooming of timeline. okay, so you can do minimal changes and perfect your sound designs, like literally 2-3 points gaps like that. Okay, I don't know if it's with video and all, but this feature actually is really great in Resolve having it. Bonus tip, here you can right click above and change whatever like it's suitable for you, like 35 feet how it will be, and samples and everything, time code. So there is a small change in automation. There is addition of send and mute. Even in the tracks also you can see that mute and send options are like for the bus on and off, and even MSIC is also a little bit updated. I guess not much, but yeah, rest all are almost the same. And there are some improvements even in the Fairlight automation stuff over here, like many you can see there in glide range and mix list, everything. Next one, batch fade settings. So let me explain you how and why, and it might be useful for you. So I am splitting these clips into several parts, as you can see there. So typically there will be many tracks, okay, like now I have selected whatever I want. So these are the things you can do, like usually the mainly fade in, crossfade or fade out will be there in a movie and audio thing, okay. So now let's try on fade in. So there are different types of graphs over here so that you can add, and like those are just, yeah, and you can see the frame and millisecond you can change over there depending upon you, which is convenient, and even overwrite existing if you want, if you have existing, okay. And then click on, yeah, and if I zoom in you can see every track on wherever it's been cut, everywhere at the start fade in is there. Like if you really zoom it in you can see the exact graph which was there, which we configured in that, okay. And even you can set the frame rate, I mean the frames, how many frames. Now let's see override, okay, here in the custom one, okay, in that we can do many things, like different types of curves, like mix, whatever, how, like random, okay. So you can see in between the clips, like starting of another to ending of another, okay, like that it will be matching. If you really zoom in then you can see the same graph again like that, okay. And now let's check out fade out, okay. You can also check in three options at same time, but I'm just gonna want you to understand. And fade out I usually attending, okay, usually attending of clips, and you have seen it there. So let's go back again and check the crossfade, what are the other two options in those, okay. So this is how seamless cuts will be made in movies like that, and you can have seamlessly made a cut or transition the audio like that, okay. Now let's go to the crossfade again. Here now I have selected equal gain, okay, which will make like equal like curves or lines or anything like that, so that it will be constant equal, okay, equal. It goes in, the left track goes down, I mean left clip goes down, right click, right track comes up like that, okay. And then now this is equal power, so there's only one option, like, okay. So you can see if you really zoom in, okay, I'm doing it over here, let me just show to you, I'm telling from so many times, okay. As you can see here, you can see how it is there. And if you take that white point, you can drag left or right, note the point, this is only for the particular thing, okay, like particular where arrow changing, nothing other will be changed, okay. And ha 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 is being done there, okay. Yeah, so let's zoom back again and let's see. If you wanna add the transition to all without selecting, you can go to and apply effects to all, okay. So this is new to Fairlight, you can go right click and export audio. So here you can see many options over here, so you can individually or like WAV or BWAV or anything like that, okay. So those are all the formats available, okay, like within Resolve export, okay. Then you can change the bitrate and everything. And here you can see there are two channel formats over here. Okay, let me show you what those are. Okay, first one, let's see interleaved. So it's audio 2, audio 1, and particular track. Okay, whatever it's in the track, it will be like that. Okay, and it's like that within the track. And next, multi-mono means separation of left and right, like audio 1 R, audio 1 L, like that. Okay, as you can see there. And next, you can change the, and you can have the source clips also exported. Okay, here you can add the tag name and everything like that in the, yep. And you can add additional information also in the bottom iMac and everything. Okay, and you can select in and out range, and yeah, the whole timeline. Yes, and loudness specification is also involved in here, so that you can specifically export it. Okay, whatever the loudness is there, normalize, you can normalize and export it. So you can even import it to media, like after it's exported, it will directly come to media pool, as you are seeing it over here. This will take some time, because if you have a longer timeline, it will take little bit time. Okay, this is half running on GPU and half running on CPU, that's why. So it might take some time, have patience. Okay, it will be so, as you can see, it came into media. So I have selected a part of the region here, like you can see the part of the region, and I'll right click export. Okay, and export, I'll just select selected range and then click. So there is a new option, if you want to clear in and out, you can go to mark and clear in and out. Okay, I didn't know I guess this is the new one in this. Okay, in mark you can go and you can just erase or clear the in and out ranges, whatever you have marked and you don't want to use it. Okay, I don't know, bonus tip. So thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe, share, like, and hopefully comment your questions. Okay, because I'll be answering them as soon as possible. Cheers.